Welcome to tonight's contest as the Rochester Zebra C team takes on the Northfield Norsemen and their C team coming over and playing at Barnhart Field. Scott Sager from RTC along with Chris Messersmith. Chris, looks like we've got a good contest. This is the first home game for the C team this year. What do you think we can expect?
Well, Northfield usually has a pretty good team. Not just the C team, but Rochester and Northfield usually compete pretty well against each other, so I think we'll have a good game here tonight.
Well, we're off to a good start. That's number 25, Liam Leininger, on the kickoff reception. Takes that down all the way to the 47-yard line. A nice return by that young man. He's a freshman this year, 5'11", coming in at 153. Hope to see a lot from Liam today.
Yeah, Liam seems like a really solid athlete for the Zebras and should be able to pull something out today.
Yeah, we're looking forward to that. We've got Hunter Nard as the center, comes up, hands on the ball. Alan Pfeiffer behind him leading the Zebras as the quarterback. Man in motion, that's 25, Liam Leininger. Round the left side, he's got a lot of room, some good downfield blocks, and he's in there. That's 53 yards, Chris.
Solid run by Liam.
Absolutely. First play of the game, Zebras out of the gates, 6-0.
That's a quick score there on the first quarter, probably about 30 seconds into the game. So
definitely a good start. I think the Zebras just totally caught them off guard there. You saw a lot of the players biting to the left, and then there goes Liam around that, the opposite left side, All the way down 53 yards for the touchdown. Zebras are lining up. They're going to try for the two-point conversion here. To the right side, that's number 24, Aaron Brooks. In for the two-point conversion right out of the gate here. Zebras leading 8-0. Players celebrating, congratulating each other. You can see Coach Weaver there. Coach Brad Weaver and Coach John Mitchell taking care of the C team this year. Both of them are varsity coaches, helping out, getting the younger players some time.
He looks pretty razzled up there.
I think he's excited. They went to their first game didn't start out so well, let me say that. So it's a good home start here for Coach Weaver and the Zebras. Let's see if they can hold on. Kick team taking the field. I didn't get a number on the kicker. We'll have to find out who that is as he kicks the ball away here. Looks like it may be number 31, Ross Pearson, but I'm not sure.
Possibly Anthony Tinsman, 32.
It's a chilly night here at Barnhart Field. Probably the first chilly night we've had all season here, and this may be a sign of things to come. Definitely feels like football weather as you see the people on the far side bundled in blankets and coats.
Oh, yeah. This cold weather has its benefits. You got football season coming up, especially for college games and stuff like that. But I got to say, I am not a fan of the cold weather.
You and me both. That was Anthony Tinsman with a kickoff down to the 27-yard line. Fumble on the play.
Looks like a Zebra recovery there.
Coach Weaver thinks it's a Zebra ball, and it is. The Zebras recover. Looks like the 32-yard line of Northfield. That's going to put him in great position. See Coach Weaver there giving some high fives, congratulating his team. They're off to a good start here. Right out of the gate, one play. They're up 8-0 now, and they've got the ball deep in Northfield territory.
Oh, yeah, I'd say this game could not be going any better for the Zebras, especially only not even a minute into the game. They score a touchdown plus a two-point conversion, and now they're in good field position for another one. So
absolutely. Pfeiffer up under center. Leininger in motion. He takes it around the left side. Busts a tackle.
Wow.
Busts a couple of tackles. A good gain there. What's that, about 6 yards?
That's probably 6 yards. 5-yard gain. run there.
He earned that one.
Yeah, he had to break a couple tackles there. There was some pushing through on the left side of the line, too, so he had to dodge a couple tacklers.
Yeah, sometimes over-pursuit is just as good as under-pursuit. Yeah. You can get past them. Well, very good. That's going to bring up second and short here for the Zebras, again leading 8-0 early in the first quarter. Pfeiffer comes up. He's under center.
Hand off to Brooks here. Going around the right side.
Brooks to the right side.
Uh-oh.
Fumble, but goes out of bounds. I think that was enough for the Zebra first down. We'll have to take a look. He got lucky there. Got to hold on to that ball. He just got lucky. He was towards the sideline there. Brooks coming in as a freshman, 5'10", 169.
Yep, and I'm seeing that most of the ball running is being done by Aaron Brooks, 5'10 freshman, and Liam Leininger, also he's a 5'11 freshman, so not a real experienced backfield, but they seem to be running the ball pretty good.
Yeah, absolutely. Technique is everything. That's number 44, first time we've seen him with the ball. Trent Bauer. It's like he's into the end zone. Not seeing a signal. Oh, flag on the play there. It's like a holding penalty against the Zebras. That's going to back him up and negate that nice run.
It'll be first and 20.
Going to make it first and 20 for the Zebras. I didn't see that holding there, but the yellow flag flew, so you think it probably happened.
Oh, yeah. For some reason, you always see them on a touchdown run, too.
Yeah, they're a little more frequent. Handoff this time. That's 24, Aaron Brooks again. Moves the pile about 3 yards back to 20-yard line, 21-yard line. Brings up second down. As I look down this roster for the C-Team Zebras, we've got our high-end Dan Clark as a sophomore, 6 foot, 267. And we go to the other end of the spectrum. We've got Alex Skiles, 5'8", freshman, at 130 pounds. So, vast array of sizes and abilities here at this C-team level. Pfeiffer up under center. He gets down low under that center.
Oh, yeah, he does.
That's 25. Liam Leininger again loses the ball. Who's that on the recovery, Chris?
That is Pfeiffer on the recovery, quarterback.
Pfeiffer following up, able to recover the ball. Like a little bit of a loss on that. Going to bring up third down for the Zebras.
I believe that's the third or fourth fumble in this game. So.
Well, as we said, the weather's changed a little bit, even as we went through the afternoon into this early evening hours. I don't know how much effect that has on the ball.
Well, I know playing in the cold is not near as fun as playing when it's a little warmer out, but you can stiffen up your arms and stuff. Sometimes you don't even feel the ball. So.
Pfeiffer looks like he's going to pass, throws back. Again, that's Brooks, 24, on the left side. A high tackle takes him out of bounds. Looks like about the 4-yard line, Chris.
Mm-hmm, I'd say.
A nice little reverse pass there to the
Brooks there. So we'll have first and 4 from the goal line.
Absolutely. Good first period for the Zebras here. Zebras line up, two wideouts. That's Ross Pearson to the far left. Far right, Leininger. It's like a little bit of a busted play. That's number 44, Trent Bauer, moves ahead for a couple. That looked like a busted play to you a little bit?
Yeah, I would say.
A bit of confusion there.
Stop for the Norseman. you can just tell when a play goes as it's structured to play out, and that just didn't seem like it went the way they wanted it to.
No, they got lucky. A little bit of confusion in the backfield, but they got a couple of yards out of it. Pfeiffer up under center. I formation. He rolls to his right for the pass. Going to keep it and walk straight into the end zone. Alan Pfeiffer walking it in for the Zebras' second touchdown of the day.
3-yard touchdown run. Getting ahead quick here, and that's always good in a football game.
Definitely like to get up early. Front line seems to be dominating a little bit here, even though we don't have a lot of girth up there. The guys are quick, getting into position, and getting those hands out there, keeping the defenders at bay.
Oh, yeah. And this doesn't seem to come up enough. The quickness of the line is so important compared to the size of the line. I would take quick linemen over bigger linemen any day.
Alan Pfeiffer hands off. That's number 25, Liam Leininger. Quick scamper up the gut for the two-point conversion. Zebras off to a quick lead here, 16-0. Northfield Zebras. You can see the Zebras, they're pumped up. They're enjoying this early start here, and let's hope that continues for them.
Oh, yeah.
If we watch hard enough, Coach Weaver may even smile yet today.
Well, if the Zebras keep playing like this, I don't see why he wouldn't.
Yeah, the numbers are down this year. I've talked to all the coaches. Football numbers are down across the board. We're seeing that trend, quite frankly, all across the Midwest and really across the country. A lot of concerns over these concussions. And Rochester's got an excellent system for monitoring and baselining these concussions, taking good care of their young athletes.
Mm-hmm.
But the football numbers are down this year, and it's nice to see that the guys that are out there are working so hard to bring home victories for Rochester and the community. Zebras getting ready to kick off here. Tinsman with a nice kick. Slides out of bounds, though, at the 20-yard line. Northfield will take over. And this will be the first play for Northfield.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
That's tough on your offense when you're 16, down 16-0 when you first get the ball.
Yeah, that doesn't happen very often.
Zebras out of the gate early with the quick touchdown, and then the fumble recovery off the kickoff gave them excellent position. They went in.
Northfield takes over.
Pretty good field position there because of the out-of-bounds kick. They're going to be starting at about the 35-yard line. Mm-hmm. So
just shy of the 35 with that penalty. Let's see how this Zebra defense can hold up here this evening.
Looks
like an attempt at a counter there. The Zebras all over that.
Oh, yeah, numerous Zebras on that tackle.
Yeah, six Zebras there, and looks like number 68 led the way. 68 is going to be Kobe Lutens. 5'10", 195 sophomore for the Zebras. He's got his hands full with that defensive tackle position.
Oh, yeah.
Down from him in the other tackle positions, number 65, Austin Foster. Got an option out here to the left. Zebras all over that.
There was nothing that Northfield quarterback could do there. I mean, he had three or four Zebras on him, and then, you know, you had the other linebackers on there.
Yeah, the pitch man was covered.
Man, yeah,
the pitch man was covered. That was Hunter Nard on the initial stop there for the Zebras. Hunter's a freshman this year.
Really?
Pitch to the right side, number 24. Zebra's really doing a nice job of just dragging that line all the way out.
Yep.
Tackled him just inside the out-of-bounds marker. That's going to bring up fourth down for Northfield.
You're taking a great pursuit angle for these outside tackles. A lot of times you'll see teams take a bad pursuit angle, and that guy can just go right around him and head up the field.
Yeah, absolutely. Good technique is what we're seeing here.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a credit to all the coaching staff here at Rochester. Northfield going forward here on fourth down. Pitch out, sweep to the left side. Zebras pursue.
Looks like they'll get that first down there.
Yeah. A little hesitant on some of the pursuit there. The guys were standing back. They could have gone straight after the tackle. Just some of those lines we talked about on the play before. Just didn't execute that well there. So that's going to give Northfield a first down. Into the first quarter here, Zebras leading 16 to nothing.
Northfield's first offensive series still in this game. So.
Yeah, they've run four plays and gone 12 yards. Pass over to the flats, number 35. Missed tackles. Finally brought down, that's number 25. Again, Liam Leininger. Zebras need to wrap up. Saw a missed tackle there. Alan Pfeiffer tried to go a little too high on that, and if he would have gone low, he could have had him back for a loss.
It's a good thing Liam got that tackle there because he probably just saved them a touchdown.
Yeah, I agree. I think he was on his way had Liam not dug him down there. That's going to be another first down, their second of the game for Northfield C team here. Got the blitz on. Oh, he's zigzagging right through the middle. Boy, nothing will make a coach more infuriated.
Oh, no.
More frustrated than a guy cutting back right into the middle of all your guys and just running right past them.
He just ran past five zebras.
Keep your head up. Keep it on a swivel, as they say. Turn around and make that tackle.
I see this a lot in C team or JV games. A lot of players will just put their hand on the guy and expect him to fall down, but you got to wrap him up or they'll just keep running.
Absolutely. Well, we're down, looks like roughly the 1.5 yard line here for Northfield. Let's see if the Zebras can hold him out here. Quarterback keeper right up the middle, number 10 for Northfield. Touchdown. Well, their offense looked great. Their defense needs a little work here in the early stages of this game.
Yeah.
Scott Seger here with Chris Messersmith from RTC. We're watching the Rochester High School C team football game versus the Northfield Norsemen C team. Rochester's up 16-6. Northfield going for their extra point.
Yep, already got three touchdowns in this game, so. In the first quarter.
John Mitchell bringing his guys together, talking about their defense. You know, we talk about the numbers, and I know we're in the first quarter, but you got to know that as we get into those third and fourth quarters, some of these C-team players are going to start to get tired.
Oh, yeah.
That's what that preseason conditioning is all about, and I know back in my day, we had two-a-days in the summer. We'd even get into three-a-days at some point.
Mm-hmm.
With the balanced calendar here at Rochester, the coaches do not get that opportunity. They get a few days with the kids in the middle of that July and a little bit of early August heat. And then they're right into the school season or school year.
Mm-hmm.
So they're doing their best to keep these kids conditioned and ready to play, especially with these lower numbers.
Yeah, I mean, playing both sides of the ball can be exhausting, especially if you got someone playing kickoff and kick return, offense and defense. They don't even come off the field. So I know how that was when I played, and it's not fun. You just get worn out.
Absolutely. And, again, when you get worn out, you get fatigued. Mistakes start to happen.
Yeah.
Tackles start to get missed. Assignments start to get missed. So let's hope those Zebras are in good condition. Kickoff comes off straight to the front line. That's number 75. Is that Dan Clark?
Yeah, it's Dan Clark. Smart play by him, just dropping there, because you don't want eight Northfield Norsemen just jumping on you there.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Anytime that front line, that ball comes to you, you just fall off.
Yeah.
Well, Alan Pfeiffer's back on the field, going to lead his Zebra offense.
They've done pretty good so far in this quarter, so we'll see if they can keep up the good drives and get another touchdown here.
Yeah, we'll see what this third possession can do for the Zebras.
Looks like Aaron Brooks got that, maybe.
Yeah, it looks like Brooks. He was trying to go around the outside, but got pulled in by their defensive end.
Mm-hmm.
Got sucked back into the middle. Short gain, maybe a yard on that for Brooks. Zebras come up, second and nine. That's a pitch. That's Trent Bauer around the right side. Sneaks behind a couple tackles and then is brought down.
Good run by
Bauer,
Trent there.
For the Zebras. Brings up a third and one.
Not quite enough for the first down. Brings up third and one for the Zebras. Hunter Nard heads to the line. Rest of the Zebras, led by Alan Pfeiffer, right behind him. Hit immediately by number 54. Should be enough for the first down. They may bring in a measurement here. Again, that's Trent Bauer.
Run. Yeah, that'll be close.
Run up the gut. Let's see what they're going to do here.
Trent Bauer, 5'7", sophomore, 154 pounds on that run up the middle. Hopefully for the first down here.
Coach Weaver calls Alan Pfeiffer, their quarterback, over to talk to him while they're doing the measurement here.
First down,
Zebras get their first down. This third drive of first quarter for the Zebras continues. Could you imagine Peyton Manning getting that low under his center?
Oh.
Here's a pitch to the right side. Cuts it back up. That's Aaron Brooks. Nice run for the young man. Some good blocking again. I'm impressed with the blockers of the Zebras.
Yeah, the right side of the line. They shoved that entire line inside and let Brooks run around the outside there. Creating a big wall there for him and letting him just push through.
Yeah, that's what you need.
Yeah.
That's what you need. Your guys enough up front to lead you the way, and
right.
You just find your path through them. So second and about 4 yards here. We're talking about Alan Pfeiffer, how low he gets. I've played Zebra football back in my day. I know
mm-hmm.
you did as well.
Yep.
As a defensive back, it's hard for me to even know who the quarterback is when he's crouching down that far.
I mean, you can lose the quarterback pretty easily when they're being sneaky like that.
Absolutely, but that's a good run right there. A strong run. Took three defenders to bring him down. That was number 25, Liam Leininger. Boy, he's showing some promise here today.
Oh, yeah, he is. It's a great athlete there.
It's like a face mask. Yep, face mask as they Northfield defenders brought him down. That's going to add some yards to an already nice play by the Zebras.
Face mask on Northfield.
Well, the Zebras take a moment here as they prepare for the second quarter here.
Untimed down.
That's why they're waiting. I could tell that the referees were not taking it to the other end of the field, wondering why here. We've got an untimed down because of the penalty on the tackle. So the Zebras get another chance to score yet this quarter.
Wow. Could get 3-1 quarter here. Offense is doing a great job here, making good pushes.
They really are. They've done a nice job with that line. Pfeiffer up under center. Handoff goes to number 24, and he powers his way in. That's Aaron Brooks again.
Strong run there by Aaron. He just pushed through, put his head down, and just told himself nothing was stopping him on that run.
Absolutely. Well, the Zebras are going to line up for a two-point conversion. They've scored 3 touchdowns, and I think I just saw that smile out of Coach Weaver.
Yeah.
That's a heck of a way to start a ball game. Now the challenge is, of course, to keep that up.
Mm-hmm. There's 3 quarters left, so anything can happen there. But if they keep playing like this, they won't have a problem.
Northfield blitzing. They take it to the opposite side of the blitz. A great offensive call there, but not enough to get him into the end zone. So that's going to be it for the first quarter here at Barnhart Field. We'll be right back with the second quarter. You're watching RTC TV. And we're ready to start the second quarter here. Zebras scoring at the end of that first quarter for their 3rd touchdown of the day. They lead Northfield 22-6. Scott Sager with Chris Messersmith with RTC TV. Kick is off. Again, that's Anthony Tinsman with the kick. Goes to about the 30-yard line. Nice wrap and tackle. What's the number on that tackler, Chris?
I think that was 31. Or it might have been Tinsman, the kicker, that actually got down there.
Yep, you got Pearson and Tinsman in on that tackle. Good job by those young men. Pretty good field position for the Norsemen.
Yeah, and their last, they've actually only had one offensive drive in the first quarter.
One possession.
It
was one drive.
Yeah. And they went for it on a first down on that drive, and they ended
up getting it. Went for it on 4th down, you mean?
Oh, yeah, they went for it on 4th down, and they ended up getting it, and they got a touchdown out of that drive. So,
yep, they stayed with it. They're not willing to give up yet. Zebras with some excellent penetration. That's number 32, Anthony Tinsman again, and number 68, we talked about him before, that's Kobe Lutens. Both with great penetration through that line. No gain or maybe a foot.
Still about 2nd and 10 or 2nd and 9 here.
Northfield comes with 2 wideouts, 1 to each side. Got motion. Blitz by the Zebras. Good block on the outside there. That's number 35. He is just tearing through Zebra defenders.
Yeah, he is.
Finally brought down by Tinsman, but a great gain there. Looked like about a 15-yard gain.
Yeah.
So the Northfield Norsemen, not much on defense so far, but their offense is cutting right through that Zebra defensive line.
Oh, yeah. I think the Zebra defense needs to do a better job of wrapping up there. And I'm seeing a lot of love taps, but it's not going to bring the guy down.
Got a pass. Incomplete. Intended for number 35. That was number 12, Alan Pfeiffer, defending. It's going to bring up 2nd and 10. Hunter Nard there waiting for the defensive calls in from the sidelines. Better hurry. Yeah, you're seeing some young mistakes there as the center came up and put his hands on the ball. Hunter Nard still had his back towards the line. Boy, that's a no-no.
Oh, yeah. That offense doesn't have to wait for you. They can snap that ball and run it.
Yeah, pass to the right side. Alan Pfeiffer slips a little bit. Number 88 with the reception. Brought down in a gang tackle. Aaron Brooks, Pfeiffer, and Liam Leininger in on that tackle.
We got third down here now.
I believe it is. Chains did not move from our angle. Right. Northfield calling out their assignments to each other.
We got a fake sweep and a run around the right side.
Oh, fumble! Boy, they hit hard there.
Oh, yeah.
The guy didn't wrap up, and that just worked out for the Zebras like a charm. Who was that? 67, Brendan Sutton, 6'1", 241 freshman.
On that recovery there?
On that recovery. Oh, that's devastating for the Norsemen. But the Zebras take over at the 14-yard line. Alan Pfeiffer comes up. He's going to lead the Zebras on this drive. Quick turn of events there. They were marching, and boy, a turnover can just take that all away, can't it?
Yeah, that can completely change the flow of the game, too. I mean, that could have been Northfield's chance at coming back, really, is with the adrenaline and the strong drive there from all the way back on their 40 or so.
Yeah, they had the momentum, and that just you saw the big swing going the other way. On that carry, by the way, that was Aaron Brooks. He went to the right side, got looks like he lost his footing underneath of him. Had a little bit of a hole there, but got tackled. Little gain on the play. Brings up second down for the Zebras. Pfeiffer under center. Looks like a blitz.
Run around the outside by Liam Leininger. Just dodging tacklers.
Cutting, yeah, he's cutting back into the middle. Look at this guy. Boy, he beat one more guy, and he had a swarm of Zebras there to form a wall around him.
He got around 10 of them, but that 11th guy.
Yeah, it's always that 11th guy. Hey, a nice job there by Leininger. Going to bring up a Zebra first down. We're in the second quarter here at Barnhart Field. Rochester Zebra C team taking on the Northfield Norseman C team. Zebras lead in the second quarter 22-6. Pfeiffer up under center. I backfield. Boy, some good penetration there.
My defense, yeah.
Yeah, that was 68. Got blown off. Kobe Lutens, we've said his name on some good terms there.
Yep.
But he got beat on that one. Looks like maybe a loss of one on that play. Brings up second down for the Zebras. Pfeiffer up under center. It's like a blitz. No, fake blitz. Pfeiffer dropped the ball. Pass almost picked off. Maybe it was picked off. On the deflection, another Norseman came in there, grabbed that ball. Let's take a look at that on the replay. As we can see here on the replay, the Zebra gets a hand on it. Northfield gets a hand on it. And then number 54 scoops in. Grabs the ball, and that's an interception.
That is an interception. I would have thought that that ball hit the ground, but after watching this replay here, and that definitely was just flipped up by one of these players and then picked off by 54 there on Northfield.
Well, if there's going to be an interception, you like for him to have to work for it a little
bit.
So, really not a bad toss by Pfeiffer. Maybe a little too aggressive, but nice play by Northfield. Pop it up in the air, the old tip drill, if you will.
Yeah.
And they take over the 45-yard line, first and 10 here in the second quarter.
Pretty good field position here to go for their second touchdown. Need about a 45-yard drive in order to get there.
Got splits on both sides. Man in motion in the backfield. Sweep to the right.
About lost it there.
Yeah, but he was able to tuck it away. Cost him a step, though, and Zebras number 24, Aaron Brooks, able to pursue on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Short gain on the play.
This Northfield offense has done a pretty good job of making their drive down the field. But last time they hurt themselves with that fumble down there around the 5 or 10 yard line. And here they are again trying to go back for it.
So they come up to the line, second down. Trailing 22-6 right now, Northfield is. Blitz by the Zebras.
Nice cuts there by 35.
Yeah, there were some nice cuts. It was a nice job by our right defensive end to force everything back inside. Yep. Need those guys on the inside to wrap up a little quicker, though. Mm-hmm. He was able to penetrate into that secondary before the tackle was made. That's going to bring up another first down at about the 33-yard line, 32-yard line, 34-yard line, somewhere in there.
Yep.
So they're marching. Let's see what the Zebras can do to keep them at bay.
That play there shows you just how important assignments are when you're playing defense. I mean, not necessarily...
Got a pass play here. Sorry to interrupt. Oh, wow.
It's an interception there by number 27, A.J. Davis.
A.J. Davis, first time we've said his name today. Boy, that ball came right to him.
Yep.
So a great heads-up play on his part. There is a flag on the play. Let's see what's happening here.
Block in the back. Zebras.
A block in the back on the Zebras. So somewhere in that three-second return of that interception, somebody pushed somebody in the back. And now, wait a minute. So they're going to take away the interception with a block on the back. No? Those are some strange signals coming out. So apparently the penalty was on the Zebras. Backed him up a little bit, but they're keeping the...
Looks like it. Yeah.
Okay. There's a pitch out. Didn't get anywhere. That's number 24, Aaron Brooks. Thought he had an opening to the right side. Couldn't quite get there. Brought down for a loss on the play. Still in the second quarter here at Barnhart Field, Rochester Zebras C team leading Northfield C team 22-6. Great first quarter for the Zebras. Struggling a little bit here. A lot of turnovers back and forth, couple of interceptions.
Yep, we've been staying on the Zebra side of the field here. So Northfield's been in pretty good field position here, and Zebra's got the full field to take over there.
Looked like a delayed handoff there, and I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but there were four, maybe five Norsemen waiting for that running back. He got nowhere. It's going to bring up third down for the Zebras.
One step can kill you.
There's a handoff. Looks like he's got some open ground. Oh, feet came out from under him. That was Liam Leininger around the left side here.
Leininger on the carry.
That's going to bring up fourth down for the Zebras.
Yeah, Northfield's doing a good job of getting to the sideline before them and containing it, not over-pursuing, but getting a good read on that.
Yeah, no, that was classic textbook even. Mm-hmm. Just take him out to the sides, and there'll be enough support there to get for you.
Yep. So it looks like Rochester will be punting here.
Is that Ross Pearson back there to punt?
Yep.
Get him right there!
Oh, short punt by Pearson. Maybe make it to the 49-yard line. Not bad.
Pretty good roll there.
Good roll for the Zebras. Northfield, opportunity here. Gets the ball in Zebra territory to start there. What is this, their third possession of the game?
Yeah, they haven't had a whole lot of possessions. And every possession they get, they end up getting close to scoring and then turning the ball over.
See if the Zebras can hold them here.
Watch
I think their second possession, they fumbled it around the 15-yard line, and then last time they threw an interception.
There's a pitch around the left side. Linebacker on that outside missed coverage. Good gain. That looked like, what, a 12-yard gain, maybe a 13-yard gain for the Norsemen. Going to bring up first and 10. Now, I remember, Chris, if you watch this Norseman line, they get up to the line and they do the little thing where they pop up and then back down. Rochester's never done that that I know of.
Yeah.
I found it to be somewhat ridiculous.
Yeah, it is pretty ridiculous. I mean, at this age, you might get somebody jumping maybe every, I don't even know, not very often, though. It kind of seems like a kiddie play thing. I don't know.
It does. And I'll tell you, again, I was in the secondary when I played. But for me, when I see those guys popping and I know the hands are already on a ball, to me, that's movement. And I want to, you know, I want to go.
Yeah, and you can get an offsides call on that even.
Yeah.
Just for moving.
Yeah. So second down here for the Northfield Norsemen. They're at the 34-yard line of the Zebras. Started this drive at the 49-yard line. They're moving the ball here. 35 in motion. Handoff up the middle. Uncontested, really, on that dive play.
Ooh.
Number 25, Liam Leininger, with another touchdown-saving tackle,
yep.
This time at what looks like to be the 1-yard line. But definitely some blown assignments there. They came right up through a dive. Didn't look like the Zebras got pushed off the ball. Just looks like some people missed some position.
Yeah.
Coach Mitchell's going to take a timeout, take an opportunity to go out and talk to the guys. After that timeout, Zebras are back on a goal line stance against Northfield from the 1-yard line. Handoff up the middle, and he's surrounded, mauled, if you will, by a number of Zebras, led by number 67, Brendan Sutton, 68, Kobe Lutens. Great goal line stance right there. Let's see if we can keep that up.
Oh, yeah, that defense wasn't letting anything through. And looks like they got another good call from their coach there. They seem pretty pumped up about this next play here.
Looks like we're going to take another timeout here for Coach Mitchell. We'll stay here during this timeout. This great goal line stance, let's hope it keeps up for the Zebras. Seeing a lot of good play out of some of the guys up front, as well as some of those middle linebackers coming in and helping out. Like to see a big play by Austin Foster here up front.
Still a scoreless second quarter here at Barnhart Field.
Quick pass, intercepted. Are you kidding me? What a heads-up play by the Zebras. That's going to end the first half of play.
That's a great play there.
With a defensive interception by Zebras. They're leading the Northfield Norsemen 22-6 here on RTC TV. And here we go, ready to start the second half. Zebra C team taking on the Northfield Norsemen C team. Zebras leading 22-6 after an excellent goal line stance there in the waning seconds of the first half.
Yep, had an interception there. Northfield was on the edge of scoring, and Zebras pulled out an interception right there on the goal line.
So the Zebras kick off to start the second half. That's number 32, Anthony Tinsman, to kick. A decent kick, taken at the 28-yard line, and number 35 puts his knee down.
Yep.
That'll give a coach an ulcer.
He looked like he had some open field there to run.
He definitely did. He could have set himself up well there. Fortunately for the Zebras, his knee did touch down, which in high school sports means you're down.
Yep.
Don't have to be touched if you knee it down. So, the Northfield Norsemen take over. First down from the 29-yard line. Let's see if the Zebras can put together a nice defensive show.
Game slowed down a lot in the second quarter. In the first quarter, we had four touchdowns. We had Zebras scoring three for 22 points, and then the Northfield Norsemen scored one. They got 6 points now, so we'll see if things can pick back up here in the third quarter.
That was number 21 with a nice run up the middle, brought down by number 32, Anthony Tinsman. Yeah, the tail of the first half, the first quarter was all about the offense. Mm-hmm. The second was all about the turnovers. We had interception, three interceptions, in fact, in that first quarter, that second quarter. So let's see what this third quarter can bring. Zebras facing second down here against Northfield.
The score doesn't really show how close this game really is. I mean, Northfield has had two or three opportunities where they should have scored, where they just turned the ball over. And if they would have scored on those possessions, then this game would be a lot closer than it really is.
Absolutely. Now, on that last play, a little bit of confusion there. You hate to see the quarterback and the running back hitting each other for any team, but Zebras really bunched them up there at the line. Brings up third down. See what the Zebras have in store. It's back to pass, out to the flats, completed. That's enough for a first down. Nice tackle. That was number two, Anthony Smith, over there in coverage. It was a quick pass. I don't think he was quite prepared for to make a play on the ball so quickly.
Nope. A lot of times it's hard to defend those flats areas. It's a pretty broad area to cover, but the big thing is being there when the guy is about to catch the ball, making sure he doesn't get a whole lot of yards. Because a lot of the yards from those plays comes from after the catch. So you got to be there to defend it.
Yeah, in that case, it was just enough for the first down to keep this drive alive. Got a blitz here. Doesn't pay off as they go to the outside. Good pursuit by number 24, Aaron Brooks. 31, Ross Pearson also went on that tackle. We didn't give Pearson enough credit for his interception there at the end of that first half. That was a one-step drop, a two-second pass, if you will, and he just put his hands up, and it was right there to end that first half.
Yep, he was there to stop that.
So second and about six. Zebras still leading 22-6 in this second quarter, or excuse me, second half, third quarter. Another pass here. Goes to that right side again. Overthrows. There's number 12, Alan Pfeiffer, there to defend if needed. Mm-hmm. Clock stops on the incomplete pass. Third down. Important down here for the Zebras.
Oh, yeah.
They need some momentum here in the second half, and this is exactly how they can get it if they can stop them here.
Yeah, it seems like Northfield has had all the offensive momentum.
Got a blitz. Again, they go to the outside. Fumble again on the ball. Looks like the Zebras did recover. Fantastic. Yeah. Number 67, there's Brendan Sutton. Good heads-up play there. And unfortunately for Northfield, if he would have just fallen right there, he had his first down.
Yeah.
You hate to see that for the opponents, but we're okay with it as Alan Pfeiffer comes up to lead the Zebras in their first possession of the second half. Liam Leininger off to the right side. We got a whistle. Too many players on the field. Sometimes you can play with 12, but typically you don't get away with it.
Nope.
Well, that gives the Zebras first and five. That's a good way to start their first possession of the second half. No change in the play. Coach says go for it. Zebras are ready. They're lined up. Oh, Pfeiffer back for a pass. And he's taken down in the backfield there.
Yeah, I'm not able to get that one off.
Loss of three on the play. Well, loss of eight, really.
Yeah.
So brings up second down and 12 for the Zebras.
Yeah, he didn't have a whole lot of time there.
No, he had the open receiver, and you saw our cameraman went and followed where he thought the receiver was going to be catching the pass.
Yeah.
But the last second, a couple of Norsemen got in there and brought down Allen Pfeiffer for the sack. Like second and 11 here, I guess, for the Zebras. They go for the sweep around the outside. That's number 24, and he can go. That's Aaron Brooks, ladies and gentlemen. He's got five lengths ahead of his nearest follower, and he runs it all the way in for the touchdown for the Zebras.
Great run by Aaron Brooks there.
Incredible run. Great blocking. You notice the penetration. They had forced everybody over to the side. He just followed right in behind his blockers and made it all the way down and then turned on the Jets.
Yeah. He cut that up perfect. If he would have gone outside anymore, he would have ran into a defender. If he would have gone inside anymore, he would have ran into a defender. So he just took that right up the field and kicked the wheels on and took it in for a touchdown.
Zebras are going for their two-point conversion here. Handoff up the middle goes nowhere for the Zebras. That was number 44, Trent Bauer, kind of looking up at his blocker saying, hey, what happened? Immediate penetration by the Northfield Norsemen. That's going to leave the score 28-6 in the third quarter here at Barnhart Field as the Rochester Zebras take on C team takes on the Northfield Norsemen C team. We see Coach Mitchell out there talking to his players, and we see Coach Weaver over on the sidelines always teaching. If you know anything about Coach Weaver, he is a teacher. He played for Southwood, one of Rochester's rivals back in, graduated in 1990. Went on to play for Valparaiso. College ball there. Did some coaching over at Manchester College for their program. Was in charge of the youth football league here at Rochester for a number of years. And now he's on the varsity coaching staff, working with the linemen there. The kids love him. He's doing a heck of a job, keeping the morale up and really teaching good technique to our Zebra linemen. This year he's taken on the C team along with John Mitchell. And so far, I like what I see.
Yeah, they've been playing good.
There's a good kick. 25-yard line. Doesn't knee it down this time. He's got some blockers around that left side. Gets quite a run back.
It's a great return. Good field position there for the Northfield Norse.
Nice job by the Norsemen. Not so nice by the Zebras. No. We'd like to see a little better pursuit on those kickoffs for them. Great field position again. They're inside Zebra territory at the 43-yard line.
Seems like their entire offense is always running in the Zebra territory.
Yeah, that's where they've been most of the game, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Hunter Nard leads his Zebras out here. Zebra defense, that is. Got a split to the right, split to the left. Got some motion. Handoff up the middle. Immediately tackled by number 55, Hunter Nard. Brings up second down. Oh, the big pitch for the sweep to the left side. He's running through traffic. I didn't see any Zebras in position to make that tackle. It wasn't like there was a missed tackle. It was honestly just good blocking on the part of the Norsemen, getting into good position, keeping the Zebras from that hole, and another first down for the Norsemen.
Yeah, they keep pushing the ball up the field. They just they can never finish.
first and 10 here. Still in the third quarter. Zebras up 28-6. We go for that big sweep around the right side this time on the pitch out. And that was enough not only to get around the outside, but to beat the secondary and get all the way into the end zone.
Mm-hmm.
Not going to make the highlight reel there for the Zebras on that one. Number 25, Liam Leininger. Seen a lot of good things out of him today. Missed that tackle. Failed to wrap up there. So that's going to make the score 28-12. Northfield's coming up to the line. See if they're going to try one or two for the extra point here.
It's looking like a field goal.
Yeah, they're going for the kick. And it's up. And just over the uprights, that's going to make it 28-13. Zebra C team leading the Northfield Norseman C team 28-13.
PAT is good. Makes the score 13-28.
Coach Mitchell getting the guys some water for the kickoff here. Calming them down.
Yeah, both offenses seem to be picking back up here in third. Maybe less turnovers as well.
Well, as we talked about, as we were in the first quarter, you know, it may be a matter of conditioning at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Getting into the middle to the end of the third quarter here. Got the fourth quarter coming up. Zebra still leading 28-13. Let's see how that conditioning plays out. Hopefully the Zebras are in a position to win it here at the end.
Mm-hmm.
And I just realized 35 is not only kicking for them, but he's also the one who does the kickoff reception for them.
Yeah.
Oh, that one not good. Caught up. Looked like it caught up under his foot.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
I don't think that was necessarily an intended onside kick as much as it just skipped up underneath of his toe. You see that in some of the younger athletics like this.
Yeah.
Zebras with fantastic field position, 48-yard line of Northfield.
Yeah, that number 35, he seems to be doing a lot for that Northfield team. I think he's picking up most of the rushing yards and he does the kick returning and the kicking. So
we apologize. We were not given a roster for Northfield, so we're having to refer to them by numbers. Pfeiffer up under center here for the Zebras. Boy, that play was dead from the beginning, but look at this guy fight. That's number 25, Liam Leininger. As you saw, he was out of position, had some guys right on him, but was able to fight through.
That was a nice move to pick up a couple extra yards there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Looks like he made it back to the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10 for the Zebras. It's number 55, Hunter Nard. Up to the line.
The handoff to Aaron Brooks there gets held up at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, the Northfield's definitely beating the Zebras off the off the snap right now, and Zebras gotta dig deep and find the energy to push them back. Brings up third and 9 for the Zebras. Still in the third quarter, 28-13 the score. Zebras leading Northfield. Pfeiffer with a pass. Looked like a little bit of a screen there to some degree. That's number 24, Aaron Brooks. And my goodness, he's off to the races for another touchdown.
Wow.
I thought Pfeiffer was dead to rights. Just threw it right over the top.
It was really great timing.
Hold on. Looks like we've got a foul. Illegal man downfield for the Zebras. I can see Coach Weaver talking to him. Referees are conferring. As it stands, it was a heck of a pass and catch from Pfeiffer to Brooks. The penalty being discussed is illegal man downfield.
Looks like they're giving it to
him. Yeah, let's see. The Zebras are celebrating. He is waving off the flag. Touchdown for the Zebras. Well, the Zebras end up with a touchdown there. It was a great play, actually. We look at the replay. 58 going in uncontested. Pfeiffer just over the top of his reach. Down to number 24, Aaron Brooks, who just turns on the Jets.
Yep.
Touchdown again for the Zebras, making it 34-13. Here still in the third quarter at Barnhart Field.
Seemed like the line let those defenders through on purpose almost, just because Pfeiffer seemed pretty prepared for those guys to come through.
He really did. I think it was a setup screen play. Yeah. 58 was uncontested, mm-hmm. which, you know, was kind of an odd thing. But 2-point conversion is good. Pfeiffer with a pitch to number 44. That's Trent Bauer. That's going to make the score 35-13.
I think he was going to go around the left side there, but saw that there wasn't much room, and he just decided to cut it straight up the middle because there's no one there. So
sometimes there's a hole there, yeah. And that's where you go. Good running backs will find those holes every time.
Yeah.
So Coach Weaver, Coach Mitchell, I'm sure are happy over their performance thus far. Still a quarter and a half to go. They got to keep the teams up. Coach Mitchell talking to his team, getting them psyched up, ready to go.
Biggest moments to be pumped up is before kickoff or kick return, because that's going to determine the rest of that entire offensive or defensive drive.
Absolutely. Number 32, Anthony Tinsman, sets up the ball. Ready to kick off here. You're watching RTC TV. Scott Sager and Chris Messersmith. I was mistaken earlier. The score is actually 36-13 with 2-point conversion by the Zebras. Number 35 with the reception again on the kickoff.
Good coverage there by the Zebras. Getting downfield.
Was good coverage, and we'll say this name, Dylan Siebert, on the tackle there, number 59. And believe it or not, Northfield's going to start.
In their own territory.
In their own territory for the first time. So, again, looks like Coach Mitchell got him psyched up, ready to go for this. Defensive series. Northfield, two wide outs. Fumble on the play. Quarterback able to drop right onto it. It's going to bring up second down.
Man, Northfield is, they're killing themselves with those turnovers.
They really are. And again, it may be weather. It's a chilly night.
Yeah.
A little bit of moisture in the air. Got the option to the left. Hits his pitch man early. Able to bust through a couple of Zebra defenders and pick up a nice gain there.
Benjamin Bauer on the stop for the Zebra. Brings up a third and six.
Zebras were able to stop Northfield on that drive. We pick up action just inside the fourth quarter. Zebras with the ball at the 50-yard line.
Ooh, Northfield just pushing with a blitz there.
Yeah, I think he jumped, but there were no flags. That was it. He just shot right through that gap.
Yeah. Pfeiffer didn't even have a second to take a step on that.
No, he didn't. That's going to bring up third down for the Zebras. Again, we skipped ahead just a little bit. Zebras were able to stop Northfield on that drive, not get much on the first down. Second down, boy, he was right in there.
Mm-hmm.
So we're here with third down. Zebras leading 36-13. That's the Zebras C team taking on the Northfield C team. We have motion and number 24 with the handoff, Aaron Brooks. Aaron fights his way until he's forced out of bounds by number 84 of Northfield. Going to bring up fourth down. Looks like 8 yards yet.
I think they're going to go for it here. I don't see why they wouldn't. But.
Well, it'd be putting Northfield in a position where they're starting further back than ever before in the game, even if they don't succeed. So, not a bad decision. Rochester with two wideouts. Looks like the blitz is coming again with a pitch to the outside. That's number 25, Liam Leininger. And Liam, boy, pushing himself all the way. Just short of that first down. That's going to be a turnover on downs by the Zebras. First down for Northfield. Again, Rochester leading 36-13. We're in the fourth quarter here at Barnhart Field.
At least I think he got it over the 50 into Northfield territory.
Yeah, I believe we're on the 40-yard line. Just shy of that first down. So it's first down for Northfield. Blitz by the Zebras, again with the sweep. Like every time we call that blitz, they sweep.
Yeah. Good defense there by the Z's, getting to the outside.
Did a nice job there. Looks like maybe a gain of one. Bring up second down. Scott Sager here with Chris Messersmith watching Rochester Zebra C team football versus Northfield. Zebras lead 36-13 in the fourth quarter. There's a pitch to the outside. A lot of Zebras pursuing.
I think Anthony Tinsman on that tackle in the beginning there.
Yeah, Tinsman did a great job. He just grabbed his jersey and wouldn't let go. Sometimes that's what you got. What I would like to see there is more players joining in on that.
Yeah.
If you get one guy to slow him down, another guy to knock him over. But didn't happen there. Northfield with a first down. Seeing if they can put some more points up on the board here in this fourth quarter. That was a very odd counter, but it worked for them. Blockers just took the, let the Zebra line straight past their counter. Handoff happened, and there was nobody there. First down for Northfield.
I think every time they run that that fake sweep counter, they pick up at least 7 or 8 yards on it. So
Zebra's got to do a better job of defending that. Wait. Got a pass here. Complete to number 35. Picked up about 9 yards, 8 yards after that reception. Because he caught it back at the line of scrimmage. Mm-hmm. And then just kind of scampered ahead.
35 is just carrying the load there for Northfield Norsemen.
Really is. You hate to build a team around one player, but he's done a heck of a job keeping them afloat tonight.
Yeah.
Northfield with a pass to the flats. Surrounded by Zebras. Gained of maybe three on the play, two.
Mm-hmm.
They'll still be short of that first down. Good spot, really.
Did a lot of running and didn't pick up too much there.
No. Third down. Yard to go. Yard and a half, maybe. Rochester's field has such a crown on it, it's hard to look as you go across.
Oh, yeah.
Nice dive up the middle. Looked like the Zebras were hesitant as if they were expecting the pitch instead. Good play calling by their offensive coordinator. That's going to be enough for the first down. They're still driving here.
That play, I just saw the big white wall push a big black wall backwards.
Yep. Now's the time to dig deep, as we've been talking about the whole game. Conditioning a major factor here with numbers being down at Rochester this year. They've mm-hmm. got to, a lot of players playing not only both ways offensively and defensively, but also on the special teams. Steps back for a pass. Little short on the throw. That's incomplete. Hits to number 33, gets nowhere. He is wrapped up immediately by number 44, Trent Bauer. Number 59, is it?
Yep.
That's Dylan Siebert again. Good defensive stand here. Let's see if the Zebras can hold on.
Let's go, defense!
There's the pitch to the outside. I could have guessed it was going to be a pitch.
Force out of bounds there by Alan Pfeiffer.
Yeah, Alan did a nice job there. I think that was prior to the first down.
Yeah, I'm thinking so. So it's going to be fourth and about five or six.
You know they're going to go for it. So yeah. Let's see if the Zebras can respond.
Big defensive series here by the Zebras. Once again, Northfield getting just knocking on the door on the end zone there and just not getting it in. But we'll see what they can do here in fourth down.
Boy, they pushed hard there.
Yeah, they did.
Nice job pushing the Zebra line back for that first down, headed towards that goal line. They're definitely in the red zone now.
Mm-hmm.
See Coach Weaver there at the bottom of your screen conferring with Coach Mitchell. If I had to guess, he's probably looking around to make sure that all the kids got some playing time today.
That sounds good.
Solid lead, 36-13 in the waning moments here of the fourth quarter. Called that play dead before it got started. Looking for the call from the referee. Look, offsides on Northfield. False start
mm-hmm.
by Northfield. Backs him up 5 yards. Takes him to the 14-yard line. Wideouts right and left for Northfield. Pitch to the right side. Zebras look like they're there. Boy, number 24 just ran over a guy.
Yeah, he's pushing it in there.
Before he's gang tackled the far sidelines.
So Northfield knocking on the door at the end zone here, trying to get their third touchdown of the game, right?
Yep. Okay. Yeah, you know, this late in the game, this is all about pride right now.
Yeah.
Zebras want to keep him out. Northfield wants to get in. So they're playing just as hard as they would be at the beginning of the game.
Yep.
Like to see the Zebras put together a good defensive front here.
Hold him!
Motion.
Yeah.
Zebras not fooled at all. Number 33 is taken down hard by number 44, Trent Bauer. Loss on the play?
Yeah, it looked like a loss.
The Zebras holding their own here.
Reminder fans, tomorrow the Zebras will be in action varsity wise against Northfield.
Gonna take a quick timeout.
Start time for the football kickoff is
you're watching Rochester Zebras C Team football on RTC TV with Chris Messersmith and Scott Sager as your commentators tonight. After that timeout, the Zebras are ready for their goal line stance again here. Northfield with the ball about the, what is that, the 10?
Yeah, probably about the 10, maybe the 9, no, 11.
Northfield with a fake pitch handoff to number 35, fooled everybody, walks it into the end zone, basically untouched.
And I was just getting ready to say how well the Zebra goal line defense has been playing so well tonight.
Well, they really were. They may not have been in their defense or in their goal line right there with the ball so far out, mm-hmm. but really a well-executed play there by Northfield.
Yeah, it was.
They've been pitching it out all night. Zebras were expecting that, and then to kind of turn it inside for that dive. Well-executed play. Looks like they're going to go ahead and go for two this time. A little bit of motion, dive up the middle, and he drags some Zebras in.
Literally drags.
So that's going to make the score 36-20. Zebras leading Northfield here in the waning moments of the fourth quarter of this ball game. Zebras will get another chance to show some offense here yet. See Coach Mitchell out there winding his kids up. Got a few kids on the sideline. See Christina Hughes, the athletic trainer there. Josh Van Meter out there, kind of the manager of the team.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of other kids out there helping. See the gold jersey there. That's Gage Messersmith. Gage fractured his hand in practice earlier this year. Had some surgery done to it. Might not see any action this year, but a definite prospect for the future of the Zebra football team. So let's see what Northfield does here. They may go for that onside kick in hopes of scoring a little bit more.
It's 36-20. Zebras are up.
He goes for the normal kick. Drops in a nice sweet spot there. Number 44 picks it up. Carries it a couple of yards. Pushes the pile.
Looked like he didn't know which way to go there. And then finally made up his mind and ran into his teammate.
Yeah, well, sometimes that happens in the game of football. But yeah. Zebras, just a little bit of time on the clock. My guess, they're going to walk out there, take the victory formation, and wrap this one up.
Yep.
Thank you. Yep, and that's what they're going to do. Victory formation here. I want to thank you for watching RTC TV's version of Rochester High School C-Team football. Scott Sager with Messersmith. We're glad you joined us today. Final score, Rochester Zebras 36, Northfield 21.